I have reviewed some laser engravers. I like a lot of them, especially the Laser Picker 2. They even come with a roller booster that enables you to engrave almost any curved surface that's impossible for others. In general, all those engravers that can engrave on many things and have really good performance, but none of them have particularly good performance on metal due to the blue light laser that has less powerful energy for engraving. So when Mr.Carve reached out to me to see if I'm interested in the M1 machine, which they claim they can carve on all types of metals.
You are right, it can carve all types of metals.
I said, why not? So here is it. This is Mr.Carve M1's prototype. I've been with it for several days and I tried all kinds of metals. Is it any good? Here's my review. Alright, first let's check out the design. It's very simple. On the base of the engraver, you get an up and down key for focusing and a power button. On the left side, there is a start button to let you start engraving when you press it. On the back, there is a power port, a pedal socket, which they said will remove on the official version, and a deadline socket. Moving up is the brain of the M1, which houses the field mirror, infrared focusing, and a giant galvanometer. We also see the ventilation there. The design, I would say, is industrial, which means it looks solid and practical, but feels less polished. Good thing is you can always put some stickers on it like I did. But compared to the design, maybe the most important part is its performance. How on earth is it? To use it, just connect the machine to your power source and computer via the cables that come with the box. Press the power button to turn on the M1. At this time, you will see two red dots on the surface of the project you want to engrave. Press the up or down keys to move the red dots until the two dots overlap. And then you're almost ready to go. Yes, welcome to M1's app. Here is the interface. And now it may look a little bit intimidating the first time views, but once you get familiar with it, you will love it, because you can control everything through the settings. Here I'm not going to illustrate every detail, I will just show the basics to get us started. If you want to engrave text, then click the T icon from the draw toolbar area and input whatever you want to engrave. You can change the font, feeling, and then click application. Of course, you have to make sure your content is within the square box. That's the printing error. As for the parameters on the right side, normally you just need to adjust the speed and power. Normally you set the speed to 500 and power to 100. And that's it. While this just use the default settings. From my test, it doesn't impact the results that much anyway. Next, click red light F1 button to preview the printing error. You can always adjust your object's position to make sure it's on the right spot. After that, click the button mark F2 and you're now ready to engrave. There is another interesting preview mode which enables you to preview the whole text like as shown in the video. You just check the red light outline box, then you will see that. As for picture printing, you click the picture icon from the draw toolbar area to import the picture you want to print and adjust the size. As for parameter settings, it's a bit more complicated than the text, but still not very much. Make sure to check boxes of reverse, grayscale, fixed DPI, and outlets. By the way, adjust the fixed DPI value to 500 and 500. The higher number means the more refined results, but don't set too high because it will take forever to engrave. 500 is enough for normal usage. Also check the boxes of two-way scanning and adjustment power. And make sure to click the application button to save. As for the speed, power, or frequency on the right side, you can keep the same as it would for engraving text. But you can also adjust a little bit, it basically has zero effect on the printing. And of course, don't forget to click to save and let it start printing. That's all you need to know if you just want to do basic engraving. The software looks complicated, but within a few minutes of learning, you will get familiar with it in no time. But of course, in order to have the best results to engrave different materials on different metal surfaces, you still need to read the manual and give it a few trials. Once you get it right, then you don't need to spend more time to learn. And now, about engraving quality. I would say the results are out of this world. They are incredible. As you can see, whether for pictures or texts, they all look crystal clear and precise. The edges look smooth and many details are being kept. It even has an outstanding performance on stainless steel. This is almost impossible with many other laser engravers that I tried previously. In addition to metal, the M1 has a good performance on plastics and leathers. But due to the infrared pulse laser attribute on the M1, it doesn't work on wood, paper, or feather material situations. One sentence to conclude, it has the best results on metal. As always, like reviewing all products, here's my pros and cons part. First, good stuff. It's fast, super fast. With this speed, I don't even need to compare with other laser engravers. It is the fastest I've had so far. Second, it's powerful and safe. Unlike blue light laser engravers, the M1 uses an infrared pulse laser with a wavelength of up to 1064 nanometers, which is penetrating. As you can see, the steel surface has been oxidized by the laser and left a pair of black ash there. So with this powerful laser, you can always get the clearest pictures, even on stainless steel. And with this power, you might think it's dangerous. Actually, not. Because of the infrared pulse laser, it won't generate blue light and hurt your eyes, and it won't hurt your hands if you accidentally touch it. Of course, I'm not using my hands, but he said it's fine, nothing happened. But for sure, I suggest you always wear protection gear when engraving. Third, I think, is the portability and the usability. And no, 6 kilograms weight doesn't sound that portable, but if you compare it to other industrial grade metal engraving machines, they normally weigh 50 kilograms. That's crazy heavy. So portability definitely is one of the advantages on the M1. As far as I know, for this 1064 nanometer wavelength infrared pulse laser engraving machines, the M1 is the smallest industrial grade home use engraving machine on the market. It's very easy to set up as well. Basically, just put up the pole and land the engraving head, screw tight, and you're ready to go. No cables here and there. Now, the less good stuff. I think for me, the major thing I don't like is the app. Unlike Laser Picker, it has an intuitive phone app that lets you engrave things in seconds, even if you're a newbie, and offers many beautiful pictures and texts for you to engrave. For the M1, you have to connect to the computer and learn to tweak this and that parameter. For sure, it's not that difficult, but still a learning curve and might look intimidating for new users. But this also comes with a good set. For those geeks or pros, they can control every parameter for engraving. That's actually a bonus, so it varies for different people. For others, it has less good performance on curved surfaces because the infrared pulse laser has a high precision for focusing. So to engrave curved surfaces, it might have uneven engraving results. The M1 feels a bit noisy too when engraving due to its powerful laser performance. But beyond all those minor imperfections, the M1 is a solid and awesome metal engraver. Especially considering the price, which you can find in the link. It's a no-brainer for anyone who wants to have a portable, consumer-level engraver where the majority of your work is with metal. This is the one. If you are interested in this Mr.Carve M1, definitely give it a check out. Link is in the description. I'm Sami, and we'll see you in the next one.